This story begins in the dark northwestern India, where some French visitors went to the Hemis Monastery and met the previous captive Tuksei Rinpoche. They were so impressed with his grace that they invited him to France. In 1981, invited by Jean Brich and Patrick Scotto, captive Tuksei Rinpoche went on his only journey to Europe, staying in the south of France, where he founded the center. Daniel Tertri and several other people from Brittany took this opportunity to join him there. Later, Kyabje Tuksei Rinpoche sent Kempo Yeshe Toda Rinpoche to France, predicting that there would soon be a place conducive to the development of the Drukpa lineage in western France. This place, known as Bel Avenir, Beautiful Future, in the commune of Pluray, central Brittany, was a small farm offered by Daniel Tertri to the representative of Kyabje Tuksei Rinpoche. When Kempo Yeshe Toda Rinpoche went there for the first time in 1985, he observed several signs of good omen. But in order to accept the gift, he wanted a financial contribution to be given to Daniel Tertri, the donor. Full of devotion towards Kyabje Tuksei Rinpoche, Patrick Scotto made that monetary donation. Later on, his generosity helped expand the area of the center until it became what it is today. Since then, Kempo Rinpoche came regularly to Pluray, starting a cycle of teachings there and giving instruction as to the structure and organization of the center, which took the name of Truktupten Tokoling. In 1987, His Holiness Gelron Drukpa honored the center with his first unofficial visit, staying there for several days. Meanwhile, more than 6,000 kilometers away, in the center of Tichur in eastern Nepal, Lama Laon Tenzin, who had served Captive Tuksei Rinpoche until his parinirvana, was undergoing his three-year retreat. It was in this sacred place that His Holiness Gelron Drukpa told him about this project.
I was in Chitre for the traditional three-year retreat, and even before its conclusion, or at the very moment I was going to conclude it, His Holiness himself told me about his project. He explained there was a Dharma center in France in which a Kempo, one of the scholars and masters of the Drukpa tradition, Kempo Yeshe Chudor Rinpoche, came to teach. But there was no resident lama in the center to provide programs on a daily basis. He told me that the few residents who were there were experiencing great difficulties in the daily management of the center because of this. Thus he introduced the matter to me, telling me that you should accept to go there to reside at the Pluray center.
In November 1989, when Lama Laon Tenzin arrived in Brittany, a region known for its severe weather, and at the Pluray center, isolated from any nearby village, he does not know much about what lies ahead.
I did not have very precise knowledge of this place, yet I knew that this Kempo, who was well known in our tradition, had gone to live in the West. I knew he lived in France. I knew he lived in a rather isolated area far from the capital, Paris. And the knowledge I had of this place is that it was located in a forest environment, very remote and rather difficult. Such was my knowledge of this place before arriving there.
It is difficult to imagine what Lama Naung might have felt when His Holiness asked him to become his representative in Europe and come to live in Pluray. But why did His Holiness Gelron Drukpa think of him for such a project?
When His Holiness told me about his project on many occasions, he said he could feel that I had the required qualities. I had long been in contact with Kyabje Tuksei Rinpoche. I had been his servant. I had acquired a number of experiences in other retreat centers. He saw in me perseverance, trust, and confidence as well as other qualities. And he asked me several times to accept the daily management of the center. At first, it's true, I had some doubts. I was both excited to go to a country that I did not know at all, to live a new experience, but I also had many fears and worries for practical reasons. I did not know the language nor the customs, nor the culture, and I did not know much about the people I was going to meet. So I felt a mixture both of enthusiasm, but also of great apprehension. This was turning around in my thoughts and in my dreams, yet, in the end, I felt it was important for me to agree. In doing so, I was giving meaning to my spiritual commitment. I was giving meaning to this willingness to help the largest number of people, to assist people and support them at each moment. So it is both with enthusiasm, but also with apprehension, that I came here.
In November 1990, His Holiness Gyalrong Drukpa came to Pluray for the second time, accompanied by his mother Mayumla and Kyabji Beru Wimpuche. He started a cycle of teachings and transmissions, which he continued by coming back regularly every year. The first prayer flags were erected at the center on the occasion of his visit in July 1991, accompanied by his mother Mayumla and by Kempo Yeshe Tudar Rinpoche. In July 1994, at the request of Lama Ngawang Tenzin and with the invaluable help of Trinle Tenzin, the first great Chakra Samvara Drupten was organized under the guidance of His Holiness Gyalrong Drukpa, accompanied by 17 monks from the monastery Drup Tukten Songak Chöling of Darjeeling. This event was also marked by the completion of the colored powders mandala of Chakra Samvara, which would not be perceived as a simple two-dimensional geometric figure, but as the representation of the plants of the celestial palace of the deity, which is a three-dimensional reality. The mandalas are extremely varied and rich in detail. On this occasion, the monks of Darjeeling performed the sacred dances, cham from the Drukpa tradition, for the first time on European soil. Traditionally, these dances are part of ceremonies which last several days and nights, and are thus visually by themselves very powerful.
The event had great results. Under the influence of His Holiness, it enabled many people to better understand Buddhism, to discover the Drukpa tradition, to experience the benefits of a Drupten, to see their devotion and enthusiasm for the Dhamma develop. For many, it was also their first connection to the Pluray Center, and with the Drukpa lineage, thereby significantly increasing the Sangha.
To start the Nam Mudra with, one must go through the common training and the uncommon training. And the common training is the preliminary practice.
In the same year, His Holiness Gyalrong Drukpa had a dream about a meditation garden with 8 houses and a temple. He drew its plan and entrusted the realization of this dream to the care of Lama Ngawang. Since his arrival at Pluray, Lama Ngawang Tenzin often thought about building a stupa in order to allow everyone to increase their virtues and merits and to follow the example of his masters. This monument of Tibetan tradition, representing the heart of Buddha and built according to a symbolic architecture, is designed to help all beings by the mere presence of statues and relics in it, and to realize the pure wishes formulated before it.
As His Holiness Gelrang Drukpa also pointed out, a stupa is built not for fame or glory, but because it has a beneficial effect on humans, the region, and the world. A stupa is built so that all the compassionate activity of the spiritual masters meets no obstacle, to perpetuate a spiritual tradition still pure and intact, and to connect the European center to the main Drukpa monastery in Tibet, Drukralung.
This was the first stupa His Holiness Gelrang Drukpa was to have built in this life. The site chosen by Khyabji Baron Rinpoche for its construction was consecrated at the beginning of 1995, after the astrologers had been consulted. On July the 22nd of that same year, His Holiness laid the first stone in the presence of the mayor of the commune. Thereafter, the construction of the Plumeray Stupa of the Good Omen Doors was to become the meeting point for many people of different religions and cultures, local elected officials, benefactors, volunteers, artists from Bhutan, contractors and workers from Brittany, all of whom contributed to building this precious monument destined to help all beings overcome the cause of their suffering and their dissatisfaction. In January 1997, His Holiness accomplished the charging of the Bumpa and the setting up of its vital tree, in which he had inscribed sacred syllables and mantras in gold-letter calligraphy. The many precious objects placed in the stupa include the statue of Buddha Shakyamuni from the Ralung Monastery in Tibet, offered by His Holiness Gyalwang Trukpa, and the very ancient statue of Taro, known to have spoken and offered by Khyabji Baro Rinpoche. On August the 13th, 1997, the stupa was consecrated in the presence of the local deputy and the mayor of the commune. This day was enshrined in a great retreat program, during which the second Drupchen held at the Plumeray Center was accomplished. event was also marked by the preparation and consecration at the center of Mendrup's sacred pillars. The monks from Nimalung Monastery in Bhutan and several monks from Darjeeling came to the Pluri Center to organize the preparations during several weeks before performing the rituals, day and night, under the guidance of His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa and Kyabji Beru Rinpoche. During all these years, His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa continuously blessed the center with transmissions and teachings, as well as advice and material and spiritual support. Under his omnipresent authority and with the support of Lama Nawang Tenzin, the center developed and hosted all the grand traditional masters. The number of students and friends of His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa increasing constantly, Lama Nawang envisioned the construction of a large meeting hall with the capacity to accommodate up to 600 people. This project started when the first sod was dug in April 2002, in company with the mayor of the commune, Monsieur Michel Morvan, and many others attending the event. Shortly after, in the fall of 2002, His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa came to bless the construction and place under the great hall the vase with the precious substances collected in different sacred places of the world and disseminating energy. The construction of the new meeting hall necessitated once again the help of several monks from Nimalung in Bhutan, who executed the paintings, sculptures and mandala, the altars and the ritual instruments. Monks from Darjeeling in India came to join them in preparing the dedication and blessing ceremony of the new hall in August 2003. For this event, the Drukchen and Mendrup pillars were once again elaborated under the guidance of His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa and Kyabji Beru Rinpoche. This episode in the history of the center was also marked by the first visit of the new Kyabji Tukse Rinpoche to the Drukpa Pluri Center. Kyabji Tukse Rinpoche assisted and accompanied His Holiness all the time. His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa said about Drukchen.
I just wanted to say that, you know, since we are doing this precious kind of grand practice, grand practice that related with the Vajrakilaya, which is your own enlightenment, your own awareness. We all are very much recommended to be aware of our life, ourself. That literally means you shouldn't. You try yourself not to be, not to lost yourself. In other words, you try to keep your awareness during this practice. Since this is a great opportunity and the mandala is great to be opened, and with the help of my father and the qualified monks from, you know, from Bhutan and everywhere, from Darjeeling, we have been we are performing, and we have been performing this mandala of Vajrakilaya.
Happiness, and also whatever achievement we have achieved so far, and also we will be achieving in our life and lives to come, to be shared with the every local people.
Dubchen is really is this a Vajrayana. Commonly, if you practice individually for maybe 10 years, it is going to be equivalent to one participating in one set of Drupchen. It is equivalent for 10 years individually if you practice. 10 years is not a short time, and you practice really diligently 10 years, but 7 days over here participating in the in a Drupchen, which you don't know very much, that's a little bit kind of, let's say, sad thing. But still, it's you have a pure mind, as I said before. So I think it is not much of missing. Anyway, you're not missing a lot. despite of having difficulties of physical sort of communication and all these things, because of the distance and because of the certain karmas and all these things, but you people should feel that you should do the practice no matter what. You should keep on doing it. The presence spiritually of the master, you know, the spiritual master, the presence of spiritual master is always there. Always there when you need it. It is not something that you have to be doubt about. If you have a doubt, as long as you have a doubt about it, then you are not really qualified. You should never have a doubt. So the key point, what you really have to do, instead of getting frustrated, you should be practicing more. The more you get frustrated, the more you should practice. That's what you should do. Instead of saying, oh, I got frustrated, where is he? He's not showing, he's not coming back. So many months I haven't seen him. Okay, let's forget about it, practice. I don't know how to practice and this and that. Instead of saying that, you should be practicing more diligently in all these things. You may not be practicing precisely and 100% correct because of the lack of whatever understanding and all these things. But I cannot also expect you to be doing 100% perfect from the beginning. If I expect that way, that's too much. I shouldn't. So a little bit error there and here, but doesn't matter. You should be putting the effort in your practice, and informally as well as formally. That's what I want to say. This is, I have been thinking about telling you many times, but this is the last chance I wanted to say in this kind of in this retreat. Since this Drupchen was done very successfully, I can assure you, whether that makes sense or not, I don't know, but I can assure you that the maximum you need to be in a samsara suffering is for 15 lives, and that's all. And you are assured and guaranteed that you are going to be enlightened after that.
In May 2004, the Pruwe Center was legally recognized as a religious community. Thus, the Drukpa lineage became the owner of unmovable and immovable property and may exercise and freely develop its activities according to its religious and spiritual traditions. His Holiness Gyalwon Drukpa named it Pel Drukpe Chotok. The Pruwe Center is the headquarters of the Drukpa lineage in Europe. Then, His Holiness Gyalwon Drukpa visited the center regularly to ensure the vast program of teachings and transmissions of the Drukpa tradition. He was accompanied once more in August 2006 by Kyabte Bero Rinpoche and Mayumla. in May 2007 by Kyabti Kantu Rinpoche, who visited the center for the first time. His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa continued to come regularly to Pluré, and he often honored the center with his presence to celebrate the New Year. His friends and students came in ever larger numbers to listen to his teachings, receive his blessings and instructions on the practices to be done, recite many prayers and wishes, and make large offerings of light for all beings. Consistency and experience of Lamangawon Tenzin were crucial to the initiations and organization of these considerable spiritual events, and to welcome His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa in accordance with the customs and traditions essential to his rank. And even if everyone was busy with enthusiasm and confidence around Lama Nawang for the preparation and smooth progress of the programs, it was obvious that his presence, his compassion, and his devotion made it all possible. Thus, it was a moment of rejoicing as His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa declared on the first day of the year 2007.
I want to thank all of them, and especially Lama Nawang, who has been really the trunk for all of us, and especially the centers in Europe. And it has been very good example for the rest of my centers in all over the world, due to his sort of generous kind of support and all these things. So I wanted to say that, you know, that he, even though he's a very humble, he has a sort of just a role to, he's playing a role, ordinary monks or lama, like everybody, like all the lamas, all other lamas. So this is the thing that he has been very much developed, not only the external movements. Of course, the external movements are the manifestation of inner qualities, from devotion to the compassion and activities of whatever I said before. The compassion has all the activities. So therefore, his beauty starts from the guru, and then, you know, then the guru gave blessings. And gave teachings and guidelines, and then through his sort of guideline that he has from his guru, then of course he has been able to be very helpful, you know, extremely helpful. for me and my lineage, and for the students and friends and all of you. You can see it from external movement of his humblenesses, yet his sort of like glorious activities in the way of leading sort of students and friends of mine, and fulfilling my wishes, and by fulfilling my wishes, he's fulfilling his own root guru, and of course he's fulfilling his sort of purpose of life and all these things. And especially you can see that, you know, his ethical point of view, like his ethical point of his life, as well as of course practical point of view, like a practical part of his life, and also of course the secret, let's say, the realizations and all these things. He has finished all these sort of like hardship retreats and all these things, and then of course he's now fulfilling my wishes and giving guidelines to everybody with very humble senses, which is very, 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 very rare. You can see many other, the lamas from many schools and all these things. It just cannot be compared to him. So therefore, I just, without taking a lot of time, I wanted to give him a scarf and just to thank him in front of you, and also acknowledge him that he deserves some recognition from me as lineage head, as the master of the retreat. So from now, today on, he is known as the master of retreat. I invite you, all of you, to sort of join together to rejoice for his recognition. A lot for the tradition and for the lineage. It means a lot, and also it means a lot for the students and friends and the lineage followers and lineage keepers. So this is traditionally, it is very much the recognition for the sake of the lineage, to thank him for the previous what he has been doing. But that is not so sort of like not very much for him, but for the lineage, and for people like you guys, he deserves to have a recognition, because he has been serving the lineage such a superb way, like 100 times better than the reincarnated. Those reincarnated lama, even I would say better than myself also, even though I sit on a very high throne and I have the name of maybe being reincarnation of Naropa and Pema Karpo and Tsongkhwa Gyari and everything, yet etc. But activities wise and service wise, he has been serving the lineage more than what I did. So therefore, it is really something that we have to be gratitude about from depth of heart. So therefore, I'm just doing it for on behalf of you guys, actually. I'm using my authority to give identifications and recognition to him as a master of retreat. Thank you.
Despite all the new constructions, the apartments of His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa remained very old, and Drupen Paksa Myongdu had often made the request to build him new housing. However, His Holiness always thought more important to focus on projects such as the stupa or the new meeting hall. Finally, with the announcement of the future visit of His Holiness the Dalai Lama to Pluray, and with the help of a generous benefactor, His Holiness asked Drupen Paksa Myongdu to begin the works on the new building containing dwellings to receive the masters, rooms for visitors, offices, and rooms for everyday work. Meanwhile, the construction of a prayer wheel started, which was going to bring the Pluray Center a new monument with a picturesque architecture, giving everyone a new means of accumulating merit and wisdom. On August 14, 2008, His Holiness the Dalai Lama arrived at the Drukpa Center and was welcomed by Captain Shogun Rinpoche, Drupen Paksa Myongdu, and the mayor of the commune, various regional dignitaries, and a crowd of several thousand people. Were waiting for him and gave the first teaching.
bouddhisme, quand on parle d'une prise de refuge parmi ce qu'on appelle les trois joyaux, le Bouddha, son enseignement, le Dharma et la Sangha, le refuge ultime, c'est l'enseignement, le Dharma. Donc, le sens du mot che en tibétain, qu'on traduit par dharma ou enseignement, dharma en sanskrit, enseignement en français, che indique l'idée de transformer, d'amender quelque chose, de corriger quelque chose, de corriger une erreur. Dharma donne plutôt l'idée de tenir, de soutenir. Donc idéalement, en même temps que cet engagement, penser que nous avons consacré l'ensemble de notre vie au bien des autres, et en tout cas pour sûr, jamais, sciemment, nuire à autrui. Bien sûr, c'est un message qui est commun à toutes les religions.
Then he went outside and gave a conference of over an hour to an audience of nearly 6,000 people who had all come to participate in this event organized by Trupa Pluré.
Depuis sa naissance, dans cette ancienne ferme, le petit centre d'études bouddhiques a bien changé. Il n'a jamais en effet cessé de grandir. Réalisation du stupa en 1997, d'une quinzaine de maisons d'habitation, du jardin de méditation, de la grande salle d'enseignement qui est derrière nous, du moulin à prière qui est devant moi, du bâtiment d'accueil. Quand on s'appelle Bel Avenir, on sait que cela ne va pas s'arrêter là.
It was the very first time that His Holiness the Dalai Lama came to Brittany. The event had a far-reaching impact and permanently anchored the existence of the Pluré Center in the spirit of the Breton population and beyond.
Lorsque des êtres se rencontrent et se sourient l'un vers l'autre, aucune barrière ne peut empêcher cet échange de sourires et de bienveillance, ni des différences et des barrières de langue, des barrières de race. C'est la même chose entre les riches et les pauvres. Il n'y a aucune autre barrière possible à cet échange de bienveillance et d'affection. Et c'est ce même altruisme et cette compassion qui amène cette joie bienveillante sur notre visage.
World peace. Yes, certainly. Peace is very important. Particularly at this moment, it's immense destructive weapons there. So once we start war and using this destructive sort of weapon, then I think the whole world may disappear. So therefore, peace is really very, very important. Now, how to develop peace? World peace. World peace will not come from sky or from earth, no. I think very clearly. Who created war? Who created violence? We human beings. So therefore, logically, the genuine peace must come through our inner peace.
His Holiness the Dalai Lama stayed overnight at the center, and in the morning of August the 15th, 2008, he blessed the hall and made a speech there.
Indeed, I'm very, very happy here. Drukpa Youth One Center here. The construction and development, it seems, I think, very, very appropriate, very good. So I hope this could be some contribution for promotion of peace through inner peace. And then basically, the Drupa Gyu is one of the very, very important part of Tibetan tradition. Now seems now 800 years, now last sort of 800 years. So during that period, many, many great masters and great practitioners has happened. So because of these great masters as a good example, still in this tradition, many practitioners really dedicated for their whole life for practice of Buddha Dharma, or particularly Tantrayana. So certainly in future also this tradition can be, I think, one very important tradition of Buddha Dharma of Tibet.
Thank you. See you again. Bye-bye.
At the same time as the European headquarters developed, the activity of Drupen Paksa Myungdu favored the emergence of several Drukpa centers in different countries. Thus, the coming of His Holiness to the Puria Center became part of an increasingly larger program, and His Holiness devoted much of his time during his recent European tours to visiting all the centers, to blessing them and teaching there. During the first Drukpa Council, which took place in Nepal, His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa expressed the wish that other scholars and masters of the lineage went to teach in Europe to share and transmit their knowledge and wisdom. Since then, in order to meet the wishes of His Holiness, Drupen Paksam Yongdu regularly organizes considerable European programs to promote and create opportunities for everyone to receive the teachings, transmissions, blessings, and spiritual influence of his precious masters. Their visit to Drukpa Pure has always constituted privileged moments conducive to spiritual practices and activities dedicated to the welfare of all beings. Jason Matenzin Palmo is a Buddhist nun who successfully fought and still fights for the right to education and spiritual development for nuns. She remained with her guru, the 8th Captive Country Rinpoche, and his community in Himachal Pradesh for 6 years. Then, he directed her to the Himalayan Valley of Lahore in order to undertake more intensive practice. She remained in a cave for 12 years. On several requests by her master and other lamas, she finally managed opening a nunnery in northern India. In February 2008, Tenzin Palmo was given the title of Tetsenma by His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa. The nun Kyabdi Drukpa Shogun Rinpoche Tenzin Choki Gyatso was born at Sonamling, the first Tibetan settlement in Ladakh, in 1968 to Tashi Chotob and Drukin Mongmo. Kyabdi Shogun Rinpoche's identity was further confirmed by the Holiness's Dalai Lama and Gyalwang Drukpa. His Holiness Dalai Lama's confirmation was based upon the identical prediction and observance of Netrung Chögyal, State Oracle, and Gadong, Second Oracle. From His Holiness Dalai Lama, he received the name Ngawon Tending Choki Gyatso and the refuge vows. At the age of 7, Rinpoche was taken to Hemis Dongchum Turling Monastery, where he was formally enthroned. After that, he was enthroned at Gadon Choko, the monastery of Sonam Drukye, Rarong Monastery in Kinor. In 1976, he received the name Tutub Dorje Gotra Gyume Trimne Gyatsute, as well as the lay Upasaka vows from His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa. He started his first teaching abroad in August 2008, where he helped Drupen Paksam Yongdu in the organizing of His Holiness Dalai Lama's visit to Drukpa Pure. Since 1980, Rinpoche has been looking after and restoring Druk Dubten Dargiling in Nyoma. He has also been giving empowerments, oral transmissions and teachings of the Drukpa lineage to the monks there. The European devotees who met him and received teachings from him had only fond memories of his humility, his honesty and his sincerity. When he was 9 years old, Kyabti Tepti Rinpoche was recognized as the fourth incarnation of the first Tepti Rinpoche from the 17th century. Today, he is the head of the Kampaga Monastery in Tibet, where he performs several duties and always acts for the benefits of the Drupa order. As a disciple of the fifth Gyalrong Drupa, Paksam Wangpom, the first Tsabtu Rinpoche, was originally at the head of the Tashu Monastery in Nangshan, Tibet. He was invited to the Kampaga Monastery in the Kham district by Tenpe Nyima, the sixth Kyabji Kamtru Rinpoche. Kyabji Tsabtu Rinpoche then became the head of this monastery. Kinzong Tenpe Gyaltsen, more widely known as Kyabji Gyaltsen Tulku Rinpoche, was born in 1953 in Tachi Yongtse in eastern Bhutan. He was orphaned at a very early age and was recognized at the age of 9 by Lopun Sonam Tsongpo Rinpoche, a disciple of Shakyashri, as the incarnation of two great masters, they themselves disciples of Shakyashri, Trulshik Lama Gyaltsen and Gyaltsen Marpa. Subsequently, he was entrusted to the first Kyabji Tuksei Rinpoche at the age of 12, under whose guidance he studied for more than 10 years in the monastery of His Holiness in Darjeeling. Upon his return to Bhutan with Lama Sonam Zangpo Rinpoche, Gyaltsen Tulku Rinpoche spent several years in retreat. Among other practices, he studied and practiced the six yogas of Naropa and Mahamudra, directly transmitted to Lama Sonam Zangpo Rinpoche by Shakyashri. Gyaltsen Tulku was then named retreat master by the Bhutanese government. He helped to strengthen the Dharma in eastern Bhutan, where he gave numerous teachings and founded 9 retreat centers.
La conque et le nectar qu'elle contient. Le sens de cela, c'est je vais vous donner, Guru dit, je vais vous donner l'initiation, mais en prenant vous, vous devez bien observer les liens sacramentels, les samayas. Avant même de recevoir ainsi la grâce, cette purification, il est nécessaire tout d'abord d'accomplir la partie du rituel qui fait descendre la grâce ici. Et le transfert de pouvoir, l'initiation est principalement établie au travers une transmission d'esprit. Donc la main fait ces visualisations, confère l'initiation, mais vous-même, vous devez aussi effectuer cette visualisation. Si vous savez la faire, à ce moment-là, vous recevez effectivement l'initiation. Si vous ne savez pas vraiment faire la visualisation, vous ne recevez pas vraiment l'initiation.
Et tu mets du beurre, et à force de le faire tourner, si tu veux,
le... Waouh! Allez, le bouchon.
In 2008, His Holiness Gyalwang Trungpa officially promoted Gyaltsen Tulku Rinpoche to Drupen, or retreat master, at Darjeeling in his retreat center of Sitri, Dechen Ursel Puk, which means divine happiness and light. He always and successfully championed equal treatment and opportunities for nuns and monks under the guidance of His Holiness and the Drupa Order.
Du centre de Drukpa Plouray. Nous vous souhaitons nos tachis d'élec, nos meilleurs souhaits pour cette nouvelle année tibétaine.
Et de réfléchir que, bien entendu, nous autres humains, nous souhaitons être heureux, nous souhaitons avoir le bonheur et des vies confortables. Mais devrions voir également que ce n'est pas que les êtres humains qui souhaitent une vie heureuse et confortable.
Gelag Namgyal, more well known as Kepje Sey Rinpoche, was born in 1963 as the son of the great enlightened yogi Kepje Apo Rinpoche. Thus, Rinpoche is the third lineage older of Dokten Trubong Dugu in both the spiritual and familial sense. He has been teaching abroad to newcomers in the spirituality of Trupa lineage and Shakeshwe lineage. Drupung Shakeshwe, aged in 1953-1919, a great enlightened yogi and Teton of the 19th century, was a great master of the Drukpa lineage of the Tibetan Buddhism, amazingly accomplished in both Mahamudra and Dzogchen, which he combined harmoniously. Kyabje Sey Rinpoche was recognized as the reincarnation of one of the heart students of Shakeshwe, the Ladakhi Tripen Pema Chögyal, 1876-1958. Rinpoche maintains and upholds the Chime Drupa Gaston Monastery in Manali, provides spiritual guidance to the Drupa communities of northern Indian Himalayas.
Thank you.
Rinpoche has become the main Drupa master to train the yogis and to provide advanced spiritual guidance to practitioners of the lineage. He assists His Holiness the Gyalrong Drupa for the preservation of the 800 years of legacy of the Drupa lineage and for spreading out its tremendous blessings. Gyabji Tuksay Rinpoche, son of the Precious Heart, was born in 1986 in Ladakh as reincarnation of the previous Tibetan yogi Gyabji Tuksay Rinpoche. He spent his childhood and adolescence in the monastery Druk Sangak Cherling in Darjeeling. Here, he received teachings from His Holiness Gyalrong Drukpa and other great Drukpa masters. In his previous reincarnation, he was the first teacher of His Holiness. He has accomplished his studies in Bhutan at the Monastery University at Tango. Gyabji Tuksay Rinpoche, together with Gyabji Khyentse Rinpoche, has settled the current long life practice in Tibetan Chaktan for His Holiness and the Drukpa masters. He already gave teachings in Europe, Vietnam, Ladakh, and Darjeeling. His Holiness Gyalrong Drukpa said about Gyabji Tuksay Rinpoche.
I was really moved to be chauffeured by our beloved Tuksay Rinpoche. He sometimes helped me as my assistant and has attended to me so lovingly. Sometimes I find it amusing. In his previous life, he was the son of my 10th incarnation and later my own teacher. Now, he is my student and follower. It is a very interesting relation, I must say.
Kempo Sonam Gyatso Rinpoche was born in 1952 in Gonjo in Kham, Tibet. He became a monk at 15 and took the vows of bhikshu from his master, the first Kyabji Tukse Rinpoche, at Druk Tupten Sangak Chöling Monastery in Darjeeling. For 9 years, he continued his studies in Buddhist philosophy at the famous University of Benares and received the title of Kempo from His Holiness the 16th Gyalwa Karmapa and His Holiness Gyalwan Trukpa. Kempo Sonam Gyatso Rinpoche has also taken part in numerous international conferences and travels regularly throughout the world to share his knowledge with numerous Buddhist centers. This erudite great master of the Drukpa lineage is well known as one of the most important scholars of Tibetan Buddhism. Kempo Sonam Gyatso Rinpoche has taught Buddhist philosophy and logic in India for the past 35 years in the Department of Buddhist Studies at the Central Institute of Tibetan Higher Education in Benares.
So that Gaboba also, he says that even the so-called Dharma practitioner, if they don't do Dharma, those Dharma can even cause you to take into the Nyansong in the lower realm. So that we should, Dharma is for peace our mind, to change our mind.
Since 1994, when His Holiness had dreamed of and had drawn the meditation garden with a small temple and 8 houses, 6 of them have been built. In September 2010, the conditions being met, work was begun on the temple, and notably thanks to Anne and Michelle Berry's legacy, Drukpen Paksam Myeongdu proceeded with the blessing of the location of the new building called Lama Lakong. Tukse Rinpoche, during his second visit to Drukpa Plure in February 2011, blessed the construction and deposited the vase with the precious substances under the foundations. This construction project, obeying a traditional architecture and involving artists and sculptors from Bhutan, will be inaugurated in August 2012, during the celebration of the 1,000 years of the Drukpa lineage. It is accompanied by another major project initiated by Drukpen Paksam Myeongdu, including more than 250 different statues representing the deities and the masters of the Drukpa tradition, which will be housed in this unique place by the multiplicity of these representations. During his last visit to Plure, His Holiness Gyalwang Drukpa celebrated the New Year 2010 with all his friends and students present and declared.
And at the end, I just wanted to express one thing that I always wanted to express, is that Drukpen Nawang, he has been the backbone or the main pillar of all these activities. And due to his effort and his kindness and also his sort of stability, you know, working and dealing with the people and the lineage, and also his love to me and also my lineage, I think all of these celebrations and all of these retreats and teachings and whatnot are created and also sort of come about. So therefore, I really want to express my many thanks, and also not only for me, but on behalf of everybody, all of you, I just want to thank him from depth of my heart. So could you just put the hand together? Thank you.